welcome. Jeff Watts here, and many of you already know me from other Friday Night Lives or other podcasts that I've done on various topics. And this is a new kind of wrinkle, something new that we're going to be doing on the Watts Atelier site on the YouTube channel. And it's me picking some of my favorite inspirational books, books that really have inspired me, that have made a huge influence on not only me personally, but as an artist, but also in my own personal journey spiritually. Because I do see this process, this journey that we're taking to become really authentic artists as really a spiritual journey. Some of you will come from different ilks, different backgrounds. This is not a plug for any particular kind of belief system or anything. It's just common sense techniques and skills and books that I've read that have helped me through certain barriers to break down certain issues I've had. I guess what you'd call our, you know, quintessential baggage that we all carry along as we go through life and deal with the difficulties and challenges of life. We end up bringing along a lot of anxiety and issues and things that we have to then face when we get into the creative process of learning how to paint, learning how to be, you know, be creative. So the book that I want to talk about today is one called Mastery. It's a very small book. It's by George Leonard. He's an Aikido master. And the way I came about this book was I was teaching a 8-day boot camp for Watts Atelier, and a girl was in the class that came up to me after one of the sessions, and she mentioned this book. She said, have you ever read George Leonard's book on mastery? And I said, well, no, I haven't. But she said, well, you say exactly the same principles, exactly the same stuff. I would have thought you have read it. So I looked up the book on Amazon, I got it, and I decided to kind of work through it, and it became a very influential book on inspirational training, understanding the process of training. I recently did a podcast on picking what school to go to, what kind of style of training that might be appropriate for your goals, aspirations. And so this kind of dovetails nicely with that. And I'll be doing a series of podcasts on how to train. They can range from training, building a schedule for yourself, to certain trajectories, to certain inspirational books like this that help get you through that. So what is the book Mastery? Well, in the book, George Leonard walks you through the examples of different people's personality types, different aspects of the master's journey. And he talks about the pitfalls, the issues, and certain personality types that are not conducive to becoming a master in anything, and the other personalities that are. And so what you're going to want to do when you read this, you might end up having to face some aspects of yourself that maybe you're not all that aware of. Or maybe you are aware of it, but it's on a very maybe subconscious level. And in a situation like that, a book like Mastery may be a little hard for some people to stomach, because you might end up reading it and saying, oh man, a hacker or a dilettante or a dabbler, that's me. I didn't really see myself as a dabbler, but I do start things and never finish them, and I always jump around, and whenever it gets hard, I have a tendency to move on to other things. So you may find, as we get into this and talk more about the different personality types, he's gonna go over keys for learning, tools for doing this. So when we start the mastery process, and I'm gonna read a little bit from notes periodically, I'll try to do most of this improvisationally, but it is difficult with the books to be able to, you'd have to read them 5, 6, 7 times, and I have read this one numerous times, to really take it to heart. These are not books that you can read one time through, like some, you know, book, a fictional book or something. It's something that you have to read over and over, and every time you read the book, you're gonna have different experiences that have occurred in your professional life, artistic life, as well as just your regular life, that are going to help you to understand it more and to see more depth in it. So when I read this the next time to actually prepare notes for this podcast, it's as if I've never even read the book ever. I mean, it was a lot of it had already gone in one ear and out the other, and a lot of the great analogies that he had used were forgotten. And then when I read it, so it took me 2 or 3 times reading it and then doing the cliff notes for it and then studying the notes so that I could then present it to you to really absorb this book properly. So keep that in mind when you're reading inspirational books, and I'm going to have a ton of them, and we're going to do a lot of these podcasts, and some of them you'll find very inspirational, I'm sure, and some you may find a little too hidey-flighty or out in left field for you or something. That's fine. I don't expect all of them to completely resonate with you, but these are just books that have influenced me greatly. So when he talks about mastery, Leonard says, the master's journey will take you along a path that is both arduous and exhilarating, It will bring you unexpected heartaches and unexpected rewards, and you will never reach a final destination. Now, this is a hard thing for us to conceive of in today's society, is everything, and he talks about this a little later in the book, which is society's fight on mastery, or the fact that mastery isn't really in vogue these days, and the principles that go along with it are almost more difficult to obtain nowadays in the internet age, where we are exposed to so much information and we have so much more time on our hands, but we also have so much more time or ways to waste that time and so many more distractions. So a lot of the younger generation, I think, is going to be battling a little bit of an uphill swim against the general flow of what mastery really entails. And it entails this idea of a lifelong journey of exploration, study, repetition, monotony. I don't like to use those words negatively because they have a negative connotation, like monotony. But a lot of people will find the sheer amount of repetition necessary to master any skill fairly arduous and monotonous. And so we have to teach you to fall in love with that monotony, with that idea of being on this trajectory that's never ending. So he says that it's open to anyone. It's not biased by race or creed or religious denomination. Mastery is our God-given gift as human beings. And it's what really separates us from the animal kingdom and most things is our ability to have free will to some degree, and that's arguable from some people. But this idea that we are in control of our destination through the decisions that we make on a daily basis. And I'm going to get into another little book called As a Man Thinketh, which is one of my favorites. And that will be a whole nother podcast because that's another book that will dovetail nicely. One of the things I found in this beginning as we talk about mastery is Tony Robbins. And Tony Robbins, many people know Tony Robbins as an inspirational kind of motivational speaker. He talks to a lot of CEOs from large companies, motivates them how to get past blocks mentally, emotionally, physically. And I have done a lot of work on Tony's programs when I was very young, probably when I was around 18. I'm 45 now. And it was instrumental in me starting the actual Atelier. But what he talks about is something called CANI, calls it, C-A-N-I. And it's constant and never-ending improvement. Small incremental improvements made on a daily basis over a long period of time yield amazing results. Okay? Now, this is another philosophy. I think it's Kazan. Toyota's philosophy, the manufacturer Toyota, they use a similar philosophy, a Japanese philosophy, for incremental improvements like that, small improvements that have helped them become one of the, obviously, the greatest car companies in the world. So these concepts have been around for a long time, and they do dovetail nicely with this mastery concept. So what I'm going to be drawing upon and trying to do in this podcast is not simply a synopsis or cliff notes of this book, but trying to apply it also to the use of it in the context of art training and how we're training and how we're trying to train. Because it's no different than training, and he uses examples of golf, tennis. Athletics is a great place to go to, and that's my background, right? So that's a really great place to go to for this type of repetitious training. And also music is another good one. Academia can also be in there. But anything that requires long and copious amounts of studying and repetition in order to gain proficiency would be under the category of probably mastery. Basically, it's a journey, it's a process. It's so cliche. I mean, we've heard it in every spiritual, I don't know, doctrine. It's, you know, enjoy the journey, it's not the destination. And it really is true in this case, for sure. So, in a moment, I'll come back and we'll talk about the plateau, which is going to be something that will hopefully need to become your best friend, but is a strange concept if you've never heard of it before.